Yo, what's up, my brother? What's up, my sister? This is your boy Oscar Ntege again with yet another amazing video. In this particular video today, I'm going to show you guys how to create more depth and dimension in your photos. And this image here in particular was done by a friend of mine called Derek of Drimax Photography. I'll leave the link of his YouTube channel in the description right below so that you guys can check out some of his awesome work. Now, I've seen many tutorials actually on YouTube trying to teach how to create more depth and dimension in an image, and there are very many panels out there that claim to be doing all this kind of dimension and all that stuff, but most of these panels cater so much to the light-skinned kind of portraits. And when it comes to dark skin and you apply most of these automated kind of actions, they tend to make dark skin look very, very, very extremely dark, darker than it is supposed to look like. So that is why I decided to create a tutorial that is dedicated mostly to people who edit a lot of dark skin people. Before we dive into this tutorial, take a minute, subscribe to this channel, give this video a thumbs up, and of course leave comments below. I just want to know what you think and what you have learned in this particular video. Most of these panels and the color LUTs that are out there on market, they cater so much to the Caucasian skin. The same applied to the Lightroom presets and the like. So this tutorial is basically to show you how to create more depth and dimension in an image. When you look at this particular image, it looks pale, and we want it to have that bit of glow, that bit of depth, without us going into the complicated thing of burning and dodging. Of course, we are going to do it a little bit, but I'm going to show you this technique using curves. Yeah, okay. So what you're going to do, you just come here, you get onto the curves adjustment layer, you click onto the curves adjustment layer, and then you're going to first work on the highlights. Let's first rename this highlights. This is for highlights, and then we are going to duplicate it again, and we're going to name this midtones. Now, the reason as to why I'm making these only two, most people do this tutorial, they show making over like five of them, is because people who are brown skinned, usually the shadows are usually too black, and you don't want to crush the shadows and to a level that they lose, the blacks lose all the details. So that is why I mostly work on the highlights and the midtones of the person. So let us first unsee this, and then we come here and we pump up the highlights just like that. See, all these highlights are going to be brought back to life. Okay, so I'll come and just double click next to it, and then get the blend if thing here, and then just drag it. And I get the highlight, that light, away from the shadow zones so that it remains in only and only the highlight areas, you know, just like that. Because the goal is just to create depth, and the only way to create depth is having that fight, that battle between highlights and shadows in an image. So you bring it up to here now to blend it so that it gets more of a soft, gradual kind of blending. You just actually press Alt on your keyboard, and then you split this, and then you take it up front until you see that it has really blended. Let me just show you. We shall just say okay. So look at this. That's the before end, that is the after. You see how we have the nose highlight pop? So we are going to come here also on the midtones, then come here. So for the midtones, I'm just going to pull them down just a little bit, just a little bit, just like that. Yeah, and then I'll close that, then I'll just double click onto this like that, and then I'll just get the midtones out of the highlight zones right there so that they remain only and only in the middle midtones, and then I'll press Alt and then split this, and then blend it in so that it goes in gradually like that. So here we see, look at this. Let me just put this in a group just for you to have a look at this. Now look at this. That's the before and that's the after. Before and after. Now we have a challenge. The challenge we have is that this thing has affected the background these particular effects have affected the background and also affected certain parts of her hair, and we don't want these effects to go into her hair. So what do we do about that? You just come here. I'll just call this the glow, because we are trying to create, okay, let me call it dimension. Yeah, just like that. So you just come here and select that dimension layer, and then create a layer mask just next to it by clicking over here. And what you're going to do, you get your brush tool, you make sure black is on top. If you see white here, you make sure you paint with black, and then you just paint over here like that. I just use a soft brush, really. I don't want it to be very as precise as can be. Yeah, but just like that. So you look at this, the before and after, before and after, before and after. So I think I'm going to have to reduce the opacity of the midtones just a little bit. Yeah, because they make seem to make her so dark, and yet she has her skin tones are not that black. So what are we going to do next? Now the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to use what they call burning and dodging, but this time using the gray layer just to emphasize the highlights even more. Okay, so you just come and create a new layer. I'm going to call it B and D for burning and dodge. Let me just rename it here, burn and dodge. I'm only going to work on one layer, so I'm just going to come here and say edit, fill, and choose 50% gray right here, and then say okay. So I'm just going to come here and change the blending mode to soft light. So I'm just going to get the burning and dodge tool, rather the dodge tool here, yeah, the way it is, and then make sure I remove the protect tones and then reduce the opacity. The highlights as well, I'm going to reduce. I just want to build it slowly by slowly. So we're going to create a nose contour over here. Yeah, and then we create also another one over here. But let us first make the nose highlight pop. So how do we do that? You get the dodge tool and then just paint over the nose contour just like that. You want to build this slowly. Let me just show you, look at this. That's the before, that's the after. See how the nose highlight gets in? Now, when you look at the chin as well, we need to make the chin also protrude, because the way the light is hitting her, it is hitting her from this direction. So we have to also make this also pop. We make also this so that she gets that Rembrandt kind of light over there. I won't dodge the forehead, it's already too bright. And then here, so the next thing I'm going to do, I'm now just going to burn certain parts. So how am I going to do that? I get the burn tool here, still I remove this preserve protections, and then I come reduce this to 10, then I leave it to midtones, and then I just get a big brush and then just burn around that area. Still I come and try to burn around that area, and then of course around that area here. Then I'm also going to come and burn over these zones around so that the face is more. I try to use a big brush so that like that. So look at this. So let me just put all these ones in a group so that we have a look at the before and after. Look at this. That's the before and that's the after. Before and after. So that is how you create dimension in an image, or dimension in a skin, without using those panels that only cater to a certain type of skin color. This is the best way to cater for black skin or to brown skin. If you're shooting people of color, I feel this would be the best route to take. Yeah, that's that for today. I hope to see you guys in my next tutorial. If you want to buy me a cup of coffee, of course, click the first link in the description below, and I'll see you in my next tutorial. And adios.